Good morning everyone, welcome to FemtoVolt Ripple. Today I'm planning to build a high voltage TPI programmer, well mostly an extension board for AVR ISP Mark II programmer. For the last few weeks, I have been looking for a small microcontroller that can perform few I/O operations. At that time, I stumbled upon ATtiny10 microcontroller. Luckily, Behnek's tutorial on the topic caught my attention. The high voltage programmer part of this video is mostly inspired by his work. I'll link his video down below. So without further delay, let's dive into the actual design. If we jump into the pin configuration page of the datasheet, we will be able to see that it has 4 I/O pins. But primarily, the RB3 pin is used as a reset pin. So, if you want to use 4 I/O pins in your project, then that becomes a problem. Luckily, we can solve this issue by programming the chip with a 12-volt reset line. And the extension board is actually designed to provide that 12-volt reset line. This is the schematic of the extension board. I mostly want to run the board with a single power supply. That's why I have added the 5-volt linear regulator. I also have added few push buttons, potentiometer and LEDs so that I can use the board as a debug tool. Here is the adapter section of the microcontroller. Finally, this is the programmer section, and this section is actually inspired by Behnek's tutorial. AVR ISP Mark II does not natively support high voltage tiny programming interface. Primarily, I can think of a few ways to prepare this section. We can use a chip mechanical relay, but the switching speed of such kind of relay is not high enough. Also, we need to add a flyback diode and few other active and passive components. Not to mention the size and the price of the relay. A better option would be to use a MOSFET. It will give you the option of higher switching speed, but depending on what kind of in-circuit chip you are programming, it may also create some isolation issue. And in rare cases, if the transistors get damaged, you may directly transfer the 12-volt to your 5-volt devices. So, if we want both higher switching speed and isolation from the high voltage side, then octocoupler can give us the best of both worlds. When the programmer board is turned on, the 5-volt signal propagates to the RST net. As the RST net is also connected to the reset pin of the AVR ISP Mark II programmer header, that pin is also pulled up to 5-volt. Inside the optocoupler, the anode and cathode pin of the photodiode is essentially also pulled up to 5-volt through R2 and R3. As both the anode and cathode are at the same potential, no current flows through the photodiode. That's why the photodiode stays in the off state. That means the phototransistor inside the optocoupler also stays in the off state. Due to that reason, the base pin of the PNP transistor is pulled up to 12-volt potential level. As it's a PNP transistor, 12-volt potential on the base pin actually turns off the T1 transistor. If T1 is at off state, then no current flows from emitter to collector, so the collector pin of T1 transistor should be in a floating state. But we can see that collector pin of T1 transistor is actually connected to the 12-volt TPI net, and that net is actually pulled down to ground through the resistor R4. Due to that reason, we will get a 0-volt potential at the collector pin of the T1 transistor and also the common pin of the S3 switch, as the common pin of the S3 switch is connected to the reset pin of the ATtiny header. The reset pin of the ATtiny10 microcontroller is also pulled down to ground. When the AVR ISP Mark II programmer pulls down the reset pin, it essentially pulls down the RST net. Due to that reason, inside the optocoupler, the cathode pin of the photodiode is basically also pulled down to ground or 0-volt. As the anode pin of the photodiode is at a higher potential than the cathode, current starts to flow through the photodiode and the photodiode turns on. That means the phototransistor inside the optocoupler also jumps to the on state, making the emitter to collector resistance of the phototransistor almost to 0 ohm. So the pin 4 of the optocoupler is pulled down to ground. Due to that reason, The base pin of the PNP transistor is also pulled down to ground. As it's a PNP transistor, 0 volt potential on the base pin actually turns on the T1 transistor, essentially making the emitter to collector resistance close to 0 ohm. Due to that reason, the 12 volt TPI net is approximately pulled up to 12 volt potential. As a result, the reset pin of the ATtiny10 microcontroller is also pulled up to 12 volt potential level. As now we know how the circuit will operate, let's build it up and program the microcontroller.
Thank you.
We are done with the soldering part. Let's prepare the sketch and burn the program. At first, I'll connect the chip on the board. Next, I will connect the LED in between the reset pin and VCC. Then I'll connect the programmer. Finally, let's turn on the power supply. I already have written a small sketch in Microchip Studio. Here, we have the declaration for port B as output. I'm turning on and off all the pins of port B at a 500 millisecond interval. Now, let's go to the tools sections, then device programming. We will select AVR ISP Mark II as programmer. ATtiny10 as device, and the interface would be TPI. Select apply to bring forward the other settings. If I press the device signature option, it shows me an error message because there is no power. Let's turn on the power supply. If we now press the read button, we should be able to see the device signature. It also shows us the operating voltage level. As we want all four pins to perform IO operations, we have to disable the reset pin feature of the microcontroller. Let's go to the fuses settings. Here, we have to check the box beside the reset disable fuse option. Let's program the pin. It will show us a warning message regarding the reset disable option, and it will also inform us that we can only unset it with a high voltage programmer. Now we have configured the reset pin as an IO pin. Next, we will go to the project settings option. We will recheck the programmer tool. Before programming the chip, we need to connect the reset pin to the 12V TPI net. By doing so, we are breaking the connection from the LED and connecting the reset pin to the 12V rail. Let's program the chip now. After the programming is completed, if we flip the switch to its previous state, we will be able to see that the LED is blinking at a 500 milliseconds interval. Let's go back to the code and change the delay to 2 seconds. If we try to program the chip in this state, it will show us an error because the programmer did not detect the chip. So, let's flip the switches and continue programming the chip. Now, if we again establish the connection in between the LED and the IO pin, we can see that our chip is blinking the LED at a 2 seconds interval. That is how we can program ATtiny10 microcontroller to utilize all 4 IO pins. Thank you very much for watching the video till the end. If this video reflects your interest, then consider subscribing. Hopefully, I'll see you on the next one.